Hi, I'm Troy Wicks, Associate Director of Coatings for North America and Canada. Today I have with me Rob Poitevent. He is the strategic accounts for our healthcare and a couple other of our divisions across North America. And we're really talking today about resinous coatings when it comes to healthcare. And there's probably not been a time in America where it's more to the person, to every single person's mind about viruses and bacteria and cleaning things. And we just wanted to talk a little bit about a project that we've got going on in Florida, kind of the reasons that we were brought into this project, how healthcare flooring and wall systems have been done in the past, and really what the future looks like for those. So Rob, with that, maybe share a little bit of how we got brought into this, what their issues were, what issues are in general in healthcare, and how the coatings that we have really are answering some of those calls.
We have a situation in Florida where a group of hospitals in Southwest Florida, there's five of them in total, are probably on average 10, 15 years old. And are in need of renovation work, and the facilities group is looking at renovating all of their ORs over the next 2 or 3 years. ORs are the revenue generating engine, so to speak, for these hospitals. So, you know, them being up and functional is a big deal. So when they go in and do this, they want to do it as painlessly as possible, but also they want to do it once and right. Have that maintain its integrity for as long as possible. So that's the nucleus of the issue. In the past, they have used sheet vinyl goods of various types and are kind of at the end of their rope, having to constantly repair heat welds that fail, dings, gouges in the floors that have to be fixed and patched and so forth. So they're looking for a more durable option. And the resinous coatings, in this case, SPARTACOTE, really checks a lot of boxes for them with the seamless application, the antimicrobial, the integral cove and base, and the durability. It's just it's a far better system for this application than they've had in the past.
Along with that, I think that, you know, when you talk about the integral cove, some of the things that are also interesting, I think, is that we're able to actually do verticals, you know, so they literally could turn a room into a bathtub if they wanted to.
Right. Yeah. They, and in some cases, especially labs, not so much ORs, but labs where it's a more or less a clean room application. That integrity is very, very important. So to go vertical, to go floor to ceiling, incorporating that with the system that's on the floor, really makes a lot of sense for them. It cuts out all of the crevices where bacteria can hide, and is really a very highly durable, sterile environment for them.
Well, and not only that, but I think that, you know, one of the things that we talk about a lot is quick turnarounds. Right. Well, maybe speak a little bit to what it would look like to install the sheet goods in a timing fashion from a SPARTACOTE system, and even that maintenance down the road, let's say 7 to 10 years down the road, what does that maintenance look like compared to what you'd have to do with sheet goods if you wanted to change or renew them?
Well, the installation, and that's one reason why in a lot of cases facilities managers will go back with another sheet vinyl product, because they know they can get in and get out in a very short period of time. And that's a key determining factor for these guys. So to bring up a resinous coating that can be installed in about the same amount of time really gets their attention. To elaborate on that, once the system gets installed, and we're talking about, let's say you're doing a hallway that is maybe 100 feet long. It's about a two-day installation, one day for prep, one day for installation, back in service the next day, which is not far off what the vinyl guys do. So once that's in place, with respect to a comparison of maintenance, vinyls have to be in a lot of cases sealed on a regular basis, if not waxed. And that's one thing that we tout as a very positive characteristic of the resinous coating of SPARTACOTE is there is no real maintenance to speak of, just simply general cleaning. We talk about a pH neutral cleaner, such as Simple Green, which is about what gets used in these hospitals. And that's it. As far as maintaining the sheen, we recommend every 4 or 5 years budget for a rejuvenation of the top coat, which is a one-day procedure, just a sanding of the surface and a reapplication of a single top coat. And it looks brand new, back in service the next day, on for the next 4 or 5 years. And that's really about it. Not so with the vinyl folks.
Well, and let me back up just a little bit on the one day. You know, I know some of our teams that are out there, you know, they'll come into the hospital or the ORs and stuff if they're just doing the redoing of the top coat, and have one crew that basically is prepping the surface and cleaning it, and right behind them, especially on the hallways, right behind them is a crew actually laying it. So when we say a day, we're actually really only talking maybe 6 to 8 hours of downtime for that area, just depending on where it's at and the nuance of it, you know, shape and stuff. But it's really an amazing difference compared to what you'd have to do with goods.
Right. No, you're right. And to say it's a one-day turnaround is being very conservative. You're right. You do the sanding, you do the reapplication, you're walking on it a couple of hours after that, you're back in full service, I'd say 12 hours after that at the outside. So you're right. One day is really being very conservative.
Now, I know also, you know, we've talked about some of the areas that we're working outside of hospitals, you know, kitchens and schools and stuff. But quite honestly, as we've been talking, you've also mentioned, you know, I forget about there's kitchens and other areas in hospitals that certainly where they would be really, really liking a resinous coating or even a urethane cement coating with a antimicrobial top coat to continue to help them along those lines of sterile rooms.
Right. And these kitchens, keep in mind, hospitals never close. So you're looking at a building that's functioning around the clock all year long. Their kitchens are not much different. While they don't go wall to wall 24 hours a day, I bet they're operational 18 hours a day every single day of the week. So they get a lot of wear and tear. And the floor in the kitchen is another key point of concern for a lot of facilities managers. If they have quarry tile in them, they have a lot of joint failures that have to be remedied. If they have a coatings issue in there, the ones I've seen more or less were either the wrong product that was put down or put down improperly. So they've got bubbling up failure issues that have to be addressed because they become a bacteria concern. So yes, that's another very, very key point to bring up is this product also can solve those problems as well.
Perfect. Hey, Rob, thanks for joining me today. If you want more information, you'll see at the bottom either Rob's information or mine, or you can go to our LATICRETE website. Thank you.